Right, here we go again, guys.
God bless you, Leeds. We have come to tell you the gospel of Jesus Christ. Gospel means good news, that there is everlasting life through Jesus Christ for anybody and everybody who believes. Because the Bible is the Word of God, and it tells us that we all have sinned and we all fall short of the glory of God, and that the wages or the penalty of sin is death. But the free gift of God, which God wants to give everyone, is everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Jesus died on the cross. He shed his blood for the forgiveness of all our sins according to the scriptures. He was buried, and on the third day he rose again from the dead according to the scriptures. And if you shall confess Jesus as Lord and believe in your hearts that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. But Jesus said, unless you repent, change your mind, and believe the gospel, you will perish, which means you will land in hell without the Lord Jesus Christ. So please, repent, change your minds, believe the gospel of Jesus Christ, because time is running out. Jesus Christ is coming any moment, and the Lord Jesus Christ shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first, and then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord Jesus in the air, in the rapture, and so shall we ever be with the Lord Jesus. The rapture is about to take place, and if you haven't already done so, then please lay hold of your salvation by believing the gospel of Jesus Christ. Don't be left behind. The gospel is that Jesus shed his blood on the cross for the forgiveness of our past, present, and future sins. He was buried, and on the third day he rose again from the dead. And if you believe that in your heart and you call upon Jesus, you will be saved. Save yourselves from this untoward and wicked generation. Lay hold of your salvation and your eternal security. Jesus said, if any man is ashamed of me and of my words in this sinful and adulterous generation, of him also shall the Son of Man be ashamed when he comes in the power of his Father with the holy angels. Lay hold of your salvation. Jesus said, unless you repent, which means change your mind and believe the gospel, you will all perish. You all have the chance to make it to heaven by believing the gospel of Jesus Christ. You all can be accepted, forgiven, and know that you're going to spend eternity in heaven. You have the choice which one you are going to spend eternity in. It's all down to you whether or not you are going to accept or reject the free gift of God, which is everlasting life through Jesus, for anybody and everybody who believes. Because the Bible makes it very clear that we all have sinned and we all fall short of the glory of God. The Bible makes it clear that the wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God, which God wants to give everyone, is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
For there is none other name under heaven given amongst men whereby we must be saved. Jesus Christ said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man is going to make it to heaven but through the Lord Jesus. The only other alternative is hell. Jesus talked more about hell than he did heaven because he wanted to warn the people. Because hell is a place of outer darkness where there is weeping and wailing, where there is gnashing of teeth, where the worms never die and the fire never goes out. And if you reject the free gift of God, which is everlasting life through Jesus Christ, that's where you spend eternity. Lay hold of your salvation and your eternal security. Repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Jesus Christ is coming any moment, and the Lord Jesus shall descend from heaven and take all believers up into heaven in rapture, and then this world is going to be turned upside down during the 7-year great tribulation, when this one world leader comes on the world stage proclaiming himself to be the Messiah. He will say, I am the Savior of the world. He will say, I am the Messiah. But he is the false Christ. He is the Antichrist. The Antichrist will cause everyone to receive a mark in their right hands or in their foreheads. 666, the mark of the beast. Nobody will be able to buy or sell anything unless they have the mark in their right hand or in their forehead. But anybody who takes the mark in their right hand or in their forehead, the same will be cast into the lake of fire, which is the second death. Please change your minds. Repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. Jesus Christ is coming. Time is running out. Please lay hold of your salvation by believing the gospel of Jesus Christ. How that Jesus paid the penalty in full on the cross for all our sins according to the scriptures. He was buried and he was resurrected to life on the third day according to the scriptures. And the only requirement for you to be saved and know that you are spending eternity in heaven and not hell is to believe on the death, the burial, the resurrection of the Lord Jesus for all our sins and call upon him. Jesus said, unless you repent, unless you change your mind from your unbelief and believe the gospel, you will all perish, which means that you will land in hell if you reject the free gift of God. Lay hold of your salvation. God loves all that he has made. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, Jesus, that whosoever should believe on him should not perish in hell, but have everlasting life, and granted a mansion in heaven according to the word of God. And if you shall confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus, and shall believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. But Jesus said, unless you repent and believe this, you will perish. Please, time is short. The Lord Jesus Christ is coming. The Lord Jesus Christ shall descend from heaven. He shall gather all believers up into heaven in the rapture. Do not be left behind. Do not reject the very one who can can grant you everlasting life in the kingdom of heaven. Do not reject the free gift of God, which is everlasting life through Jesus Christ, for anybody and everybody that believes. The Bible makes it very clear that we all have sinned and we all fall short of the glory of God, and that the wages of sin is death. But the free gift of God, which God wants to give everyone, is everlasting life through Jesus Christ for everyone that believes. Jesus died on the cross. We all know that Jesus died on the cross. The Son of God shed his blood on the cross for the forgiveness of our lifetime of sin. He was buried, and on the third day he rose again from the dead according to the scriptures. And with the heart, man believes and is justified, just as if he'd never sinned, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation, that if you shall confess Jesus as Lord and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. But Jesus made it very clear that unless you repent, change your mind and believe the gospel, you will perish. There is a heaven and there is a hell, and there's only one name under heaven given amongst men whereby we must be saved. Jesus Christ said, I am the way, the truth and the life. No man comes to the Father but through me. Jesus said, I am the door. By me, if any man shall enter in, he shall be saved. Be an any man, be an any woman, lay hold of your salvation, be sure of your eternal security in Jesus Christ. Immediately after the rapture of the church, immediately after Jesus takes all believers up into heaven, immediately after will start what Jesus described as the great tribulation. 7 years when God shall pour out his wrath and his judgments upon an unbelieving, unrepenting world, which has turned its back on our Father, the Creator. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts, and let him return unto the Lord, and unto our God, for he will abundantly pardon. Jesus will not turn anybody away who comes to him in truth. God isn't asking us to get all religious. God isn't asking us to go to church every Sunday. God is only asking one thing, that you have some faith and that you believe on Jesus Christ, his only begotten Son. Jesus was clearly crucified on the cross to pay the penalty for all our sins, past, present, and future sins. He was buried, and on the third day he rose again from the dead. And if you shall confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus, don't be ashamed to call upon Jesus. And when you believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. But please do not hesitate. Please do not wait any longer, because Jesus Christ is at the door. He's about to descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first, and then all believers which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord Jesus in the air in the rapture. And then this world is going to be turned upside down, where God shall pour out his wrath and his judgments upon an unbelieving, unrepenting world which refuses to acknowledge God our Father.
Just stop this one and upload it quickly, guys. A lot of people giving me thumbs up and the usual F off and stuff like that. See you in the next one, guys.